This is the solution to written homework 59. Okay, so part A. The volume as a function of R and H is pi R squared H. Part B. The surface area of the cylinder as a function of R and H is, well, the two disks are easy enough, so that's pi r squared plus pi r squared. This is slightly more complicated. Only when you try to think, only before you see it. So this cylinder is this measurement is the height of the cylinder, and this right here, this measurement is the circumference of the cylinder. So circumference which is 2 pi r. So that's one disk plus one disk plus 2 pi r h. So simplified, that would be 2 pi r squared plus 2 pi RH. Okay, then for part C, minimize the surface area. Okay, so the objective function is the surface area. So S of R and H is this thing here. 2 pi r squared plus 2 pi r h. The constraint function, which I'll call C of r and h, is pi r squared h, and then minus 1024 pi, because the constraint, remember, is going to be equal to 0, is the constraint. So that's saying that the volume must be 1024 pi. Okay, so then the critical points. Be the solution to this system. So the R partial of the objective, so that would be 4 pi R plus 2 pi H is lambda multiplied by the R partial of the constraint. So that would be 2 pi RH. So the H partial of the objective would be 2 pi R. It is equal to lambda multiplied by the h partial of this times pi r squared. Okay, and then the constraint that pi r squared h, the volume, must be 1, 0, 2, 4 pi. Okay, well, let's number these. 1, 2, 3. So, when I solve this system, it seems to me that the easiest thing to start with is probably from equation 2, since it has the least variables. So, from equation 2, I see 2 pi r is lambda pi r squared, and I want to solve for lambda. So the first thing I can do is divide by pi. How about I divide by pi r? So if I divide by pi r, the new left-hand side is 2, and the new right-hand side is lambda r. So you can, it's possible to do this. You can make this step, this division by r, because r is a positive quantity, because this is a cylinder. So then we could solve for lambda by dividing by r again to get, what, 2 over r is lambda. Okay, so that was from equation 2. Now we can take this, I think, and plug it into equation 1. So I'll put that into equation 1. So in equation 1, that's 4 pi r plus 2 pi h is lambda, but lambda is 2 over r, so 2 over r, and then 2 pi r h. Okay, so then the r's cancel. We get 4 pi r plus 2 pi h is, so the 2's combined to make a 4. The r's cancel, and we get 4 pi h. So we can divide everything by 2 pi. Or even, I'll subtract 2 pi h from both sides. So 4 pi r is 2 pi h. That's even better. So now we can divide both sides by 2 pi. So 2 r is h. Okay. So what does this mean? This means, so this, means the diameter to r is the same as the height. So that's the interpretation of that. And now we could take this and put it into the last equation that we haven't used. So we haven't used equation 3. So we'll put that into equation 3. So h can be replaced with 2r, so that gives that pi r squared, and then h, so we get another 2r here, 2r is 1024 pi. So we could divide by 2 and we could divide by pi to obtain that r cubed is 512, and if I'm not mistaken, that 8 cubed is 512, yes, so r is 8. And now we could take this and plug it into this one up here to determine h. So if r is 8, that means that h is 16. So this here, 8 and 16, is the location of the minimum. So that's how you get the minimum. And the minimum value is what you get when you plug that in. So the surface area when you plug in 8 and 16 is that value there. So when r is 8, that's 64 times 2 is 128 pi, so 128 pi as a result of the caps. And then 2 pi rh is 256 pi. Which is 256 plus 128 is 384. Pi. This is the minimum value. So again, like we discussed in lecture, these optimal shapes all have nice properties where some things are equal. And in the case of the optimal cylinder, optimal cylinder occurs when the diameter is the same as the height.